the age of 18 months, infants reach a developmental milestone known as the vocabulary spurt. During this time, they start learning new words in an amazing speed. It is estimated that the reason for the sudden increase is a change in the way they understand words. Instead of associating each single word to an object, they understand the principle that words refer to objects in their environment. This referential understanding is one of the basic elements of the human language. A handful of studies document the ability of a few dogs to rapidly learn names of objects, mostly dog toys. These studies suggest that similar to infants, the dogs comprehend the referential aspect of object names. And yet, little is known about the ability of dogs to learn object names. One study described how a dog was able to learn the names of over 1,000 objects after being exposed to a very intensive training protocol that included 5 to 6 hours of professional training each day for 3 years. In another study, dogs were able to learn the names of new objects after hearing their names only 4 times, but their memory declined rapidly after only a couple of minutes. So, can dogs learn multiple new object names without intensive training? How many object names can they learn? And can they form a long-term memory of these object names? To answer these questions, we tested 6 border collies that already knew the names of multiple objects. As the dogs live in different countries, the experiment was conducted using an online streaming software. To raise public awareness to the research, we broadcasted parts of the experiment on the Genius Dog Challenge YouTube channel. In the first experiment, the owners had 1 week to teach their dog the names of 6 new toys. They did this by playing with their dog with 1 toy at a time while repeatedly saying the toy's name. Most of the owners played this game with their dog for about 30 minutes a day. At the end of the training week, we tested the dogs. We placed the 6 new toys on the floor. And just to make things a bit more difficult, we also added 10 of the dog's old toys. To make sure that the owners were not giving any visual cues to help their dogs, we asked them to sit in a different room. From that room, the owners sent their dogs to get 1 toy at a time by saying the toy's name.
Super!
Yeah, super!
After every 3 trials, the owners placed the toys back. So the number of toys from which the dog could choose always varied from 16 to 14. Each of the new toys was requested 2 times. In the second experiment, we doubled the difficulty level and asked the dogs to learn the names of 12 new toys in 1 week. Again, we tested their knowledge at the end of the week. We used the same testing procedure, but this time, in addition to the 12 new toys that were on the floor, we added 8 of the dog's old toys. To test the dog's memory of the toys' names, a week after the second experiment, the owners tore the toys out of the dog's reach. After 1 month, we randomly selected 6 of those toys and used them to test the dog's memory of their names. We placed these 6 toys on the floor together with 8 of the dog's old toys, and the owner requested each toy 3 times in a randomized order. To see if the dogs could still remember the names of the toys even after 2 months, we repeated this test using the remaining 6 toys from experiment 2. In experiment 1, the dogs retrieved the correct toy in 85% of the trials, showing that they have successfully learned the names of between 5 to 6 toys. In experiment 2, the dogs retrieved the correct toy in 87% of the trials, proving that they have learned the names of between 11 to 12 new toys. In the 1 month memory test, the dogs have shown that they remember the names of the toys by retrieving the correct toy in 61% of the trials. The dogs also remembered the names of the toys after 2 months and retrieved the correct toy in 57% of the trials. We found that the dogs not only could learn the names of up to 12 new toys in 1 week, but also could remember most of those for up to 2 months, This rapid learning occurred during natural social interactions and did not require intensive training. Not only did the dogs demonstrate a learning speed which is comparable to that of 18-month-old infants, but they also did so under a learning context which is in many aspects similar to the natural interactions occurring between adults and infants on a daily basis. Our findings suggest that dogs with a vocabulary of object names can be a powerful model for studying the mechanisms of word acquisition in a non-human species.